James Clark Ross. Sir James Clark Ross FRS FLS, April 15, 1800, April 3, 1862, was a British Royal Navy officer and explorer known for his exploration of the Arctic with Sir William Parry and his uncle, Sir John Ross, and in particular, his own Antarctic expedition from 1839 to 1843. Biography. Arctic exploration. Ross was born in London, the nephew of Sir John Ross, under whom he entered the Royal Navy in 1812, accompanying him on Sir John's first Arctic voyage in search of a Northwest Passage in 1818. Between 1819 and 1827, Ross took part in four Arctic expeditions under Sir William Parry, and in 1829 to 1833, again served under his uncle on Sir John's second Arctic voyage. It was during this trip that a small party led by James Ross, including Thomas Abernethy, located the position of the North Magnetic Pole on June 1, 1831, on the Boothia Peninsula in the far north of Canada. It was on this trip, too, that Ross charted the Beaufort Islands, later renamed Clarence Islands by his uncle. In 1834, Ross was promoted to captain. In December 1835, he offered his services to the Admiralty to resupply 11 whaling ships which had become trapped in Baffin Bay. They accepted his offer, and he set sail in HMS Cove in January 1836. The crossing was difficult, and by the time he had reached the last known position of the whalers in June, all but one had managed to return home. Ross found no trace of this last vessel, William Dorr, which was probably crushed in the ice in December 1835. He returned to Hull in September 1836 with all his crew in good health. From 1835 to 1839, except for his voyage with Cove, he conducted a magnetic survey of Great Britain with Sir Edward Sabine. Antarctic exploration. Between 1839 and 1843, Ross commanded HMS Erebus on his own Antarctic expedition and charted much of the continent's coastline. Captain Francis Crozier was second in command of the expedition, commanding HMS Terror. Support for the expedition had been arranged by Francis Beaufort, hydrographer of the Navy and a member of several scientific societies. On the expedition was Joseph Dalton Hooker, who had been invited along as assistant ship's surgeon. Erebus and Terror were bomb vessels, an unusual type of warship named after the mortar bombs they were designed to fire and constructed with extremely strong hulls, to withstand the recoil of the mortars, which were to prove of great value in thick ice. In 1841, James Ross discovered the Ross Sea, Victoria Land, and the volcanoes Mount Erebus and Mount Terror, which were named for the expedition's vessels. They sailed for 250 nautical miles, 460 kilometers, along the edge of the low, flat-topped ice shelf they called variously the Barrier or the Great Ice Barrier, later named the Ross Ice Shelf in his honor. The following year, he attempted to penetrate south at about 55 degrees west, and explored the eastern side of what is now known as James Ross Island, discovering and naming Snow Hill Island and Seymour Island. Ross reported that Admiralty Sound, which he named Admiralty Inlet, appeared to him to have been blocked by glaciers at its southern end. Ross's ships arrived back in England on September 4, 1843. He was awarded the Grand Medaille d'Or des Explorations in 1843, knighted in 1844, and elected to the Royal Society in 1848. Search for Franklin's Lost Expedition. In 1848, Ross was sent on one of three expeditions to find Sir John Franklin. The others were the Ray Richardson Arctic Expedition and the expedition aboard HMS Plover and HMS Herald through the Bering Strait. He was given command of HMS Enterprise, accompanied by HMS Investigator, because of heavy ice in Baffin Bay he only reached the northeast tip of Somerset Island where he was frozen in at Port Leopold. In the spring he and Sir Francis McClintock explored the west coast of the island by sledge. He recognized Peel Sound but thought it too ice-choked for Franklin to have used it. In fact, Franklin had used it in 1846 when the extent of sea ice had been atypically low. The next summer he tried to reach Wellington Channel but was blocked by ice and returned to England. Personal life. He was married to Lady Anne Coleman. He died at Aylesbury in 1862, 5 years after his wife. A blue plaque marks Ross's home in Elliot Place, Blackheath, London. His closest friend was Francis Crozier, with whom he sailed many times. He also lived in the ancient house of the Abbots of St. Albans in Buckinghamshire. He is buried with his wife in the local churchyard of St. James the Great, Aston Abbots. In the gardens of the Abbey there is a lake with two islands, named after the ships Terror and Erebus. In fiction. Ross, played by British actor Richard Sutton, is a secondary character in the 2018 AMC television series The Terror, portrayed in a fictionalized version of his 1848 search for Franklin's lost expedition, as well as in the 2007 Dan Simmons novel on which the series is based. Tributes.